The Queensland Health Minister has denied the Palaszczuk government has been pushed around by the state's teachers' union in the management of COVID in schools. She's also defended the Chief Health Officer's lack of knowledge about the number of unvaccinated teachers.
Riding the Omicron roller coaster, in the space of just 10 days, Queensland families have been given three versions of how the school year will play out. First, they were told the return of school would be delayed 2 weeks to allow time for children to be vaccinated. 2 days later, they learned the school year would then be extended by a week to compensate for the lost Term 1 lessons. Now, after bitter complaints from the teachers' union, that extra week will be scrapped. Question on behalf of those tens of thousands of parents who had to make new plans with the delay of school's return, what would you say to those who are asking who runs the state, the government or the teachers' union?
My recollection at the time is Minister Gray said, we're looking at extending the school year by a week and we'll work with the teachers and the teachers' union about how best to do that. I am very pleased that the profession has been able to find a way of working that curriculum and that learning into the school term so that that is not needed.
The Health Minister was then questioned on whether one hand of the government knew what the other was doing when it came to managing COVID in the education system. How can the public be convinced that this government, your government, has an efficient cross-government approach towards COVID when your own Chief Health Officer admitted yesterday he has no idea about the number of unvaccinated teachers? Why hasn't someone from education briefed his department on the extent of that potential problem?
The Chief Health Officer can be provided with that information on any given day, any given time. But to be honest, I mean, that is not something that the Chief Health Officer needs to get preoccupied with on a daily basis. It is not for the Chief Health Officer to be reaching into education and asking operational questions about how many are vaccinated or not. That is education's job to do that.
The Health Minister then turned defence into attack, targeting the Prime Minister over a federal government advertising campaign she claimed the states simply weren't able to deliver.
It is not Scott Morrison who is standing there at these testing clinics having to deal with the abuse of people who are unhappy because they can't get a free test. And to run these ads now, knowing this, is just, I think, absolutely appalling. And Scott Morrison should be apologising when he knows that supply is not available right now.
Queensland has reported 16 more COVID-related deaths of elderly people, bringing to 45 the number of those who have died in the current Omicron wave. Adam Walters, Sky News.